Good morning and happy Vlogmas day 13. You saw Yaniv and I go to a jam cafe for breakfast, and I was kind of underwhelmed. The pancakes were all right, they were a little bit dry. The tater tots were really good, but again, our philosophy is like if it's fried 9 times out of 10, it'll taste absolutely amazing. And then Yaniv really did enjoy his egg, and he said the sausage was absolutely delicious, and it was like a patty sausage instead of one in a casing. So he said he really enjoyed that, and it tasted really homemade and really, really good. Overall, it was kind of an eh for me. Again, I have a very limited amount of things I can eat, especially when the menu is just fully an egg menu. I know my pancakes did have egg in them, but again, baked goods are a little bit on like a lesser scale of what triggers my eczema versus eating like full on, like over easy eggs or scrambled eggs themselves. But overall, it was good. It was fun. I hope you enjoyed the footage and the B-roll from the last clip. And now to get to packing. So today is gonna be pretty much a packing day, organizing day, sort of tidying up here in the Airbnb, and just pretty chill as far as like a day goes, but definitely it'll be very, very busy for me while I'm packing up everything. I hope you enjoy this time lapse. Of the packing is done. Oh my gosh, look at all the athletic green we just shoved in this little pouch. But most of it is done. That empty side with Yaniv's So Right, which why did we bring that? Who knows, but he did use it once, so it's justified. But we're waiting for the laundry, and then whatever's left over will be folded and put over there. And then that's it. We are pretty much all packed up, ready to go back to Toronto and for our flight tomorrow, which you guys will see in the vlog the day after. Yes, because you'll be seeing this vlog the day we're actually flying. So wish us good luck. Yaniv and I were kind of feeling a little bit poopy after that little brunch breakfast. So we've only been like picking on things here and there and not really eating much just because our stomachs were definitely very unsettled. But I figured I'd make some tea and hopefully sort our stomachs out before dinner comes along. We have some water boiling, cups. I'm gonna have some of my candy cane crush. It's a black tea with some peppermint. I feel like the mint will do my stomach some good, and I'm gonna make Yaniv a nice chamomile tea. So I've recently made a few online purchases, and I thought it'd be fun to walk you guys through how I do that, how I think about it, how I come across a lot of the things that I purchase online. And I did make a Sephora order, so I wanna show you like how I dissect the new incoming items on there and decide what I want to buy. So normally when I get on the website, I like to look around and see what's in the new tab. So usually I go for skincare, makeup, and just sort of like peruse what we've got going on. So right off the bat, something that caught my eye was the Fenty new gloss balm cream. And this is one that I saw many different times in many different places. And I just love how, like, look at these shades.
Look at these colors. Oh my gosh, they look so rich. And I love the original gloss bomb, like the clear lipstick with like the sparkles and shimmer in it. So I was so excited when these released on Instagram and Rihanna did like her little rendition of using them through like, I think it was IGTV or maybe just a static Instagram post, but damn, they look so cute. So I was going through so many swatch reviews and I was trying to find somebody who had similar like skin tone and features as me. And the conclusion I came to was basically that I was going to get Fenty Glow, which is like the original gloss bomb color, but in a darker cream color. And I feel like it's like that universal Fenty color. So it works well on most skin tones. And I feel like my lips are pretty brown, so it will even out if there's a little bit too much pink in this formulation, but I'm excited to try it and I will be swatching it for you guys when I get it. And the other one that was just like, boom, I had to get it was Fruit Snacks, and that's a berry red. And I was like, it is the holiday season. I want to be a little bit like festive and glam. So I will be definitely doing like a holiday look with this lip color. I thought it was just so, so, so perfect. Going back to the What's New page on Sephora, I usually go to the skincare next. Once I have like one makeup item or two, that's usually enough. And I bought two of these cream colors. I bought it in the Fenty Glow and the Fruity Snacks or Fruit Snackin' or the berry color. And now I have two things that actually caught my eye when I was scrolling, and that's one from Pharmacy and one from Glow Recipe. Now, the Pharmacy was a whipped greens and it's an oil-free foaming cleanser. And now this one caught my eye because it's for combination and oily skin, which is what I have. As you can see, it's like nearing the end of the day. Actually, it's not even the end of the day. It is 4:15 and I already see like some shininess that's going on, and I have like acne prone skin too. I do get breakouts, so I felt like this would be right up my alley. I really do enjoy Pharmacy's product. I don't use them as often because they can be on the pricier side of skincare, and I tend to really like go through my skincare, but I figured like it's in a good size bottle and I can make it into a travel size bottle like quite easily. So I was very, very intrigued by it and I did pick it up. And another product that caught my eye was the Glow Recipe Watermelon Glow Niacinamide Dew Drops. Now, I've been using niacinamide from the Inky List and I really do love that formulation. It's simple, it's small, it's travel friendly, and Yaniv's skin has been loving it. His nose was so oily before, and once we started incorporating a little bit of niacinamide like throughout the week, his nose has been so spotless and like the pores look cleaner. I'm just so impressed, and I do recommend putting niacinamide in your routine. But this one was cool because it had the niacinamide, the watermelon, and hyaluronic acid. I don't have hyaluronic acid as a serum form in my routine already, so I felt like this would be like a great two-in-one to bring with me when I'm traveling. It is 40 milliliters, so it's really easy. A few drops, just adding it before a moisturizer and sunscreen. I thought this was perfect. I love the idea of a good glowy, dewy look, and the fact that it's helping my sebum, which are any of my oily zones, plus giving me a nice overall glow on like my more dry areas, I was like, yes, please sign me up. So I definitely picked up this product. And again, when I do receive these products in the mail, I will be doing an unboxing. So your girl is excited. Another thing that I recently purchased that I was really, really excited about. Here we go. So, oh, I spelled her name wrong. Oops. Okay. Jamie Page here on YouTube. She is the sweetest, the cutest. Like, I just feel so happy whenever I watch her videos, and she's also Canadian and I love supporting Canadian creators, and just her little, like her start to her small business is so, so precious, and it has so much spunk to it. Like a lot of her designs are like bitter bleep perfume, coffee and milk print, colorful lip gloss, like they are so cute. So I actually purchased two of the Happy Holidays cards, and I will be gifting those to, I think I know who it is, but I'll save that for like when I do my wrapping and like gift prep video in a few days. But I am so excited to gift these. These are the cutest freaking cards to exist, And I swear I would pick up more if I had known. They are just so, so, so cute. But I don't need as many because I've already picked up some other cards. But so, so cute. Her sticker packs, in case you're wondering and you're into stickers, they completely sold out. Like, look at this. Fruity pack gone, caffeine pack gone, the makeup lover gone, perfume again gone, like bad bleeps cry two sticker. They are so cute and I can't wait until they come back in stock. They sold out so quickly and I'm so happy for her, but they are really cute and I definitely will be adding those to my wish list of things that I want in the future. So another thing that I recently mentioned on my channel is Situ Beauty, and it is more recent, but I've been using her product for quite some time. Hers is the facial roller that's actually stainless steel. Super great because it's non-porous. It is so, so, so cold and it feels so great on the skin. It's super de-puffing. And I actually purchased a new set because I wanted to break it up and give my mom the facial roller and keep the gua sha that it comes with for myself. But yeah, her products are so, so great. So I purchased this kit. They're actually on sale right now, so 25% off your entire order. Pretty sick if you're interested in picking them up. But I ordered them quite some time ago because I wanted them to come in time to gift to my mother. But I am so excited to get the gua sha. My mom already owns like this body gua sha thing that she has that can be used on the face. It's like a little bit bigger than the one that Sarah sells, but this one is so cute and I'm so excited to get it so I can travel with that and the facial roller to really work out any tension I have in my face. And I'm so impressed with this product. I have had no complaints, except for maybe that it's a little bit heavy, but I feel like you want a product to feel like heavy and luxurious whenever you're using it. And that is basically it for this little segment of Shop With Me. And I hope you enjoyed it. It is something new and I can do it more often because I do find myself making purchases every so often, if it's for reviews on the channel or just for myself when I'm gifting to people, especially because it is the holiday season. I would love to show you what I bought for friends and family in a video. So let me know if you'd be interested in that. Hit the thumbs up button and yeah, let me know. So I just wanted to come in here and end today's vlog. I have some order in pho and all of the fixings. It is like the vegetarian version. So here are my noodles and everything inside. I'm really looking forward to eating this because it's nice and warm and it's a little bit chilly outside. But that is it for Vlogmas Day 13. I hope you enjoyed and I'll see you tomorrow for Vlogmas Day 14.